temper while writing. You know, if, when you are writing a complaint letter, there must be a lot of anger in your heart. There must be a lot of anger, lot of annoyance in your mind. But be calm while writing letter. Do not show your anger in your letter. Your words should be very much polished, polite. Show courtesy in spite of being angry. You should show courtesy in your letter. That is very important to maintain business relationship. Even we don't want to create further relations, but we should not end the relation with the negative tone, at a negative tone. So courtesy is very much important. Courtesy costs nothing. It just pays. It wins the sympathy. Courtesy wins respect. Courtesy wins mutual understanding. That is why courtesy is very important in business relationship. Courtesy can be shown in various ways. If you reply letter timely, that is also a way of showing courtesy. If you don't respond letter, that again is a discourteous. Let us see the examples of rude statements. Send the goods within week. Here in first statement, there is no word of courtesy. Look at the second sentence. Please send the goods within a week. The second sentence is more polite than the first one. Avoid using negative words. Never use words like foolish, untrustworthy, unreliable. Such words should be avoided. It again creates very wrong impression. It again spoils the business relationship. Keep in mind that customer is always right. He may be wrong. We might be knowing that he is wrong, but still, you know, as the boss is always right in a firm, for the business person, customer is always right. That should be kept in mind. So don't write negative words for customer. But at the same time, you should not flatter the customer. You should be firm. Your tone should be firm, not rude. Be firm, but don't be rude. That should be kept in mind. Courtesy means keeping smiling even in the difficult situation. As I told you, you might be angry, but you should not show your anger in your letter. Let us see one more example. You failed to supply goods on time. The first sentence is not very, it doesn't show courtesy. You should not use the negative statement like you failed to supply. Instead of that, you can say, perhaps you are not aware of the fact that goods are delayed. Second sentence is shows little bit courtesy. It's better than the first one. You should, after writing letter, read it once. If you feel that you are not bored or you are not annoyed after reading, that is very important. Write letter to please the reader. Even answering the complaint letter, if someone complains about you, you feel very bad, you feel very annoyed, you feel very upset, but don't show your annoyance, upsetness in your letter, right? The next C is consideration. Professor Prajapati would talk about the same.
Consideration. Everybody in the world thinks that he is the center of interest. We know that the business letter writer writes a letter to gain something, but he should present it in such a way that the reader realize that the letter has been written to get the benefit. Means the letter will be benefited to the reader also. Here are the points. Consideration of the recipient of a letter is of utmost importance. Satisfy the customer's interest. Consideration should be reflected in the language of a letter. The businessman should satisfy the customer's requirements, customer's interest, and that will be a positive matter about the letter writer. The consideration can be shown through two ways. One is the personal approach. It depends on the choice of words and the active sentence structure. Personal approach. When we use personal pronouns like I, we, you, that will give a personal touch to a letter. In the sentence, inconvenience caused to you is regretted. This sentence doesn't have the personal pronoun. I or we are missing there, and the structure is also passive. Whereas the next statement, I regret inconvenience caused to you. Here we find the use of personal pronoun I, and the sentence structure is also active. So in this way, the personal touch can be given to the business letter. Another example, a branch of our company is being opened at 10 a.m. today in your town. You are cordially invited. Again, a passive structure is used. The subject is missing, whereas the second sentence, we are opening a branch in your town. We cordially invite you to its opening ceremony at 10 a.m. today. So, personal approach can be given to the sentences through the use of personal pronouns, particularly through the use of I, we, and you. So, here the reader comes to know that the letter writer personally is interested to invite the customer or the reader. The other thing is the you attitude. Talk to the reader from his point of view. Customer should realize that the purpose of the letter is to benefit him. This recipient oriented approach is known as you attitude. You is at the center. Generally, while writing, we use I or we, but one should keep in mind while writing a letter that the writer should put you at the center. Therefore, the reader or the client will think that he is also given the equal importance. Emphasize you instead of I or we. In the letter, as I told you, we should write the sentences that begin with I, with you instead of I or we, to give the importance to the reader or the client. Avoid a self-centered focusing on your interest. It is clear that business writer writes a letter to get the benefit, but he should present it tactfully. He should shift the interest, his own interest, to the customer. So he should try to avoid a self-centered focusing on your on his own interest. It is very much clear from the examples. The first example, we are pleased to announce that the bank is going to open a new branch soon. We are pleased. हमें खुशी हो रही है, हमें खुशी हो रही है कि. And the another example, you will be pleased to know that the bank is going to open a new branch soon. Look at the beginning, you will be pleased, आपको खुशी होगी कि. In the first sentence, we is emphasized, हमें खुशी हो रही है. That means we is at the center, the writer is at the center. Whereas in the next sentence, you will be pleased. You, that means client, customer or the reader is at the center. That means the writer has put stress on the importance of the reader or the customer also. Next is, it is an approach, it is a psychological method of winning favor. So your attitude is a psychological method how to satisfy the ego of the customer or the reader, and through that the businessman can get the favor from the reader or the customer. A mechanical use of many U's is unnatural. It appears to be a trick. Here I would like to add one of the Hindi sayings. Naman naman mein fair hai, bahut name nadan, dagalbaaj do guna name, chitta chor kaman. The customers are clever enough to distinguish the means they can readily understand what you are going to say. Jyada naman ka difference they know very well. That's why be careful while using this you. It should not be unnatural. Your company has made a new camera for you. Your company, how can it be the customer's company? Obviously, the company belongs to the businessman, and that has made a new camera for the customer. Here, nothing is wrong, but the pronoun your is inappropriate. Instead of your company, there should be our company has made a new camera for you. From all these points, we can conclude that the business letter should be correct, clear, concise, convincing, complete, courteous, and conversational. So all these points, the points that begin with the letter C, they particularly talk about the body of a business letter. Do you agree?
Yes, very
true. Yeah. What is the structure of a business letter? That talks about the regular and the occasional parts of a business letter.
Yes, sir.
The regular parts. Heading, the date, salutation, inside address, the body of the letter, complimentary clause, signature.
They are the component of business letter. They just show the physical appearance of the letter.
Yeah.
Business
and
letter.
Also the occasional parts.
Occasional parts.
There are 7 or 8 occasional parts.
Yeah.
They talk about the outward appearance of a business letter.
Yeah. But as real beauty lies within.
Yeah.
The real essence of business letter lies in its content.
Right.
And content should be on basis of this principles of business letter. And these 7 C's are not a watertight compartment. Like, they can be overlap, you know.
Yeah.
Clarity, concreteness, completeness, they overlap each other. They are not a watertight compartment.
The number of C's differ from person to person.
The number of C's differ from person to person. Very true, very true.
Yeah.
And you know, there can be more C's also if we want to add.
Yeah.
Convincing.
Yeah,
letter
of course.
Should be convincing.
Coherence.
Creative. Coherence. Yes, the logical link should be maintained. That is coherence.
Yeah.
You know, the lines should be connecting each other. Like the first salutation comes, then your introduction comes. If you write inquiry letter, introduce yourself, then put forward your order or your point. That coherence also is very important. So you can add C for coherence also.
Yeah, right.
Again, at the same time, your letter should be creative.
Yeah.
Be creative enough to convince the reader. But still, as I explain you while clarity, that don't use too much flattery language. That is good for article writing, essay writing. But when you write this formal letters, business letter, come to the point, right? Yeah. To the point.
Yeah, that means these 7 C's or more than 7.
Yeah.
They may be. They talk about the internal quality of a business letter.
Very true.
The body of the business letter. And that is very much important. If the body is not to the point, it is ambiguous, unclear, then the letter is means it is vague, general. The letter will not convey the proper meaning to the customer or a letter from the customer to the businessman. So if the student prepares the 7 C's, what are the 7 C's, what are they talking about, if the students are aware of them, then they will be able to write a letter with a qualitative body of the letter.
Qualitative letter, very true. An effective letter.
Yeah.
Because the entire business depends on the letter.
Yeah.
The whole transaction, business transaction depends on the letter. The businessman may not know who is writing the letter. He may not know him personally. He may not meet him personally.
Right.
But just through correspondence, through letters only, they maintain the entire relationship, entire business relationship.
Yeah. That means, in short, these 7 C's answer the question, how to make the business letter more effective.
Very true.
Yeah.
Very true. Not even in business letter, in any kind of communication, this C's should be taken care.
Yeah, right.
You know, even in verbal communication, one should be very clear. One should be very accurate while of using correct grammar, correct pronunciation.
Yeah, right.
Correctness is also used everywhere, not only in business letter. All these 7 C's.
Everywhere it is.
Is for all type of communication, is for all type of correspondence.
Yeah.
That is again very point to be noted, you know.
Yeah.